From the new home of the Atlanta Braves, MLB Network welcomes you to SunTrust Park, the Midsummer Classic between the American League All-Stars and the National League All-Stars. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special coverage of the Major League Baseball All-Star Game here on MLB Network. I'll be joined in a moment by Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, but first, let's give you a look at this year's American and National League All-Stars, as voted on by you, the fans. Final preparations being made on the field. We've got a fun night in store. It's the Major League Baseball All-Star Game on MLB Network, and it comes your way next. Getting close to first pitch here. Let's listen in to public address announcer Alex Miniak.
And now, the National League All-Stars.
Briefly now, we'll look at the two men named by their managers to get the ball here to begin this All-Star game. Number 37, the right-hander from Arizona, will be doing the pitching. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
All right, so here's how the National League All-Stars line up on D. And guys, let's take a look at Rafael Devers. Got rushed to the big league super quick because the guy could flat rake. Defense has lagged a little bit behind. Had some throwing issues early, but working on his craft and continuing to get better every year.
Digging in, Kent Clemens. And we are set for baseball here this evening.
The American League, the center fielder, Kent Clemens.
Now here's the pitch. Good slider there, and he gets ahead of him, nothing and one.
First pitch, 7-0-5.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Liner towards second. And a good throw gets him, one gone. And now we'll look at the starting lineup for the visitors in this one. Mark, what's your take on him against one of the best starters in the game?
Well, Matty, you look at this lineup. The key to success is scoring early, putting the other team on their heels and allowing their own pitcher to go out there and feel like he can execute his game plan and attack and stay in the zone. This offense needs to get on the board.
Now in the box, Lewis Glenn, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one.
The left fielder, Lewis Glenn.
Here's the first pitch to him. Nope, and that misses ball one. And nope, there are our umpires calling balls and strikes is Mr. Ed Drummond.
Yeah, Matty, we got a good one behind the dish today in Ed Drummond. Well-liked by all people, pitchers, batters, managers. All you want as a player is the ability to talk to someone. And that's what Ed does. He gives you that chance.
D-Row, you hit the nail right on the head. He has a real long fuse. He's not afraid to let a hitter or a pitcher, I'm not say complain about a particular pitch, but he's not the guy that's going to get mad and throw somebody and give him the boot just because a guy doesn't like a pitch or a pitcher thinks that a pitch is a strike and they call it a ball.
Oh, he pulls the string on the circle change, 1-2.
I'm pretty surprised by the location on those last three pitches. The book on him is that he hits the away pitch pretty well, and he just saw three in a row out there.
So does he go back out there again?
No, Matt, I expect him to mix it up. Most catchers won't call for the same location over and over and over.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Lewis Glynn is the second out of the opening frame.
Batting third.
Into the box, Robert White. Weak grounder down the first baseline. This is foul for the first strike. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Ground ball right side. Barter has it, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Nothing doing here in the opening half inning. It's the American League nothing, National Leaguers coming to bat. It's the Major League Baseball All-Star Game, exclusively on MLB Network. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Franchy Cordero. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Franchy Cordero.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Ball one as he lays off below the zone. A dive and he knocks it down. And a good try to recover that time, but he'll beat it out as he's aboard to kick off the inning. Next will be the designated hitter, Kenny Vick.
Hey, that's great hustle right there out of the box. Not everybody's getting it right out of the chute from step one, but I have to ask you, Dan, how frustrating executing a pitch and there's an infield knock.
It is, D-Roy, and you can read that right off the bat as a pitcher. You can read the angle. You know that that ball is going to be hit on the ground, and you're thinking deep down inside, okay, there's a quick out, and it just wasn't meant to be.
Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2.
I know he got a swinging miss right there, but that was a hittable location to a really good hitter. I don't know if he gets those back if he continues to miss in those spots.
They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
All right, so here's how the National League All-Stars line up on D.
If you were to describe right field in one word, I think it would be cannon. And that's what this guy brings to the table, an absolute cannon to go along with great range. Don't test the arm.
Stepping in, Bobby Law.
Batting sixth. From the Seattle Mariners, the third baseman, Bobby Law.
First pitch on its way. Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. The 0-1 pitch. And he fouls this one off. No score here as we play inning number two. Got him. That's back-to-back strikeouts now as they've been unable to advance that leadoff single into scoring position.
Yeah, clearly no problems working out of the stretch right now, Matt. He's taking control this inning after giving up that hit. Now we'll see if he can finish it off strong as well.
The first baseman, Joe Shaw.
He's set and the pitch.
One.
A bouncer up the middle. Scooped up. Throw in time and the side is retired. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. On now to the bottom of the second. And we are tied 0-0. Julio Urías, a lefty standing 6 foot even, takes over the pitching duties here.
Number seven, Julio Urías.
Well, this one had its moments of drama and excitement. In the end, these guys came away with the victory and look on to the next one.
5-2. 2-2 the final score tonight. The National League All-Stars led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Julio Urías is the winning pitcher of record. So that's a wrap for us here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Mark DeRosen, Dan Plesac, and the entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB Network. Have a good night, everybody.